starting to dig in the ground or get caught on trees or passing whatever happened to be there on the battlefield, the way they hung over the side. So they shortened the guns to this length, you can see here, or much shorter looking if you compare them again to the Mark I. The last remaining Mark I is in our trench display. Also on the Mark I's, there's wheels on the back. Now those wheels were to try and act as almost like a rudder to help the vehicle steer as it was driving along. They had a compression unit on the back that would actually push them down into the ground or raise them up when they were thought they weren't useful. They were found to be utterly meaningless. On that first tank attack, one or two vehicles had those wheels knocked off or knocked off by Sherman soldiers. This is the Honey tank. Officially it's the M3 Stuart, an early model Stuart tank, radial engine, aeroplane engine, pieces of the vehicle as it was in that film. Of course, most of the tanks in the interior are not fully stowed, and it makes a little contrast with some of the vehicles. And the Sherman, again, despite being brought over by our friends from the Dutch Army, this is a Leopard 2, the next version of the tank. Collection of vehicles and their military used, and they take them to shows and take some of the historic vehicles to memorials and anniversaries. And we've been really privileged to have this vehicle here today, being able to be driven around by the Dutch crew, and it gives us an opportunity here as well. You can see that difference between the earlier Leopard 1s and this Leopard 2 here.